I'll keep the focus on L3. Okay. And I'm gonna say that I'm extremely inspired and proud of my daughter for developing an organization such as L3. And one of the main reasons is because of my teenage years. I was a homeless girl at one point, and I literally slept on the ground. When I say homeless, I mean homeless, sleeping on the ground in the dirt. And there was nobody there to help me. There was no organization such as L3 available to a young girl like me at the age of 15, 16, and 17. Those were some of my hardest years. I think I know who that is. Those were some of my hardest years in my lifetime because I was abandoned. Well, I mean, I can go all the way back to not knowing who my parents are in the very first place. But the people that raised me, who I thought were my parents, at some point in my life, in my teenage years, they abandoned me. And so I ended up on the streets. They took my son, which is my oldest son, and he was registered with Missing Exploited Children Hide and Seek Foundation, Nevada Child Seekers. It took me 20 years to find him. So in the midst of having lost my son and then trying to still survive and function mentally and physically, you know, I ended up on the streets. And you find out who's really in your corner when you find yourself all the way to the ground. And I mean literally to the ground. People say they're your friends, but you'll find out when you really need them the most. And at the time in my life when I needed someone the most, I actually felt like committing suicide. But of course, you see, I didn't do that, right? And it wasn't meant for me to do that because I feel that the Creator had a plan for me in my life and my future. And of course, you would never have met Samantha and been a part of L3 and the things that she's done in this world if I had made a terrible decision like that. And that was long before she was even thought of being born. So during that time in my life, it was really hard for me to have to be on the streets. I had no food to eat. I had to steal food. I had to go in the stores and steal because it was nobody would give me food. And I didn't know what else to do. So I did what I had to do in order to survive. I did what I had to do in order to continue to move on. And I went through a lot. I went through abusive relationships. Once I came off of the streets and, you know, ended up in a relationship, which I was taken off the streets by this relationship, and I ended up, you know, being abused. So in this life, to try to condense it, like she told me, to give you a little piece, right? So to try to condense it and let you young ladies know, and young men know, that you can do it. You can do it. You can survive. But you have to be strong, and you have to just simply don't give up. Don't let nobody tell you that you can't do it. Or don't let nobody make you feel like, oh, I'm messing up, and this is just not gonna work, and life is not gonna be worth it. Life is always worth it. At a point in my life when I thought there was nobody, I said, my son is being stolen from me. He's gone. I don't have my mother, I don't have my father, I have no sisters, no brothers, no nieces, nephews, aunts, uncles, cousins. I have no one on this earth to be here for me. So why am I here? Why bother to stay here? I might as well take myself on out of here. I might as well call it a day and commit suicide. What's my purpose? But something said no. You have a purpose, and you're going to continue to have a purpose. I stand here now before you as the Las Vegas Queen of Gospel. I have a house that I live in, fully furnished. I drive a Mercedes Benz, drop top. I have three beautiful children, And I tell you, I'm excited and I'm happy. I'm so proud of my daughter for L3. So she has created something that is amazing, that would have been the best thing for me if someone like her had come along when I was on the streets, it would have been a godsend. So what you ladies are doing, young man, what you all are doing to help L3, I can't even, look, this is a joke. I say it to my kids, I tip my weave to you, okay? You know, because you are amazing people. My daughter, her vision is totally impossible, and she has made the impossible happen. And I'm so proud of Miss Samantha Vance for L3, and I'm proud to be the mother.
Ladies learning to lead rocks.